If you've ever looked at the suspension setup on a professional motorsport-based car such as the Oreca LMP2 behind me and wondered what is exactly going on, then you can be forgiven. There's definitely a lot of complexity in the suspension. So I thought we'd take the opportunity here at Jota Sport to dive in and talk a little bit about how the system works. Starting with the dampers themselves, these are pushrod actuated through a bell crank system, not particularly unusual there. They are four-way adjustable for bump and rebound. So how this works is that we have separate adjustability for high speed and low speed bump and rebound. Now that's nothing to do with the speed of the car. Instead, it's really talking about the velocity of movement of the damper. In general, the low speed damping is for aspects that are under the driver influence, such as how the car moves when the driver moves the steering wheel, so this affects the driver feel for the car. High speed is more to do with the way the car tracks over bumps in the road, so the suspension or damper setup can be adjusted to optimize both aspects separately. An interesting aspect with these dampers is they also have a fifth adjustment for a blower valve. Now, how this works is that if the driver needs to run the car over a curb, this can end up upsetting the car balance, so the blower valve can be tuned to allow the damper to move very quickly when the driver does hit the curb. This isn't something that will be done all the time, but on some tracks there may be a particular corner where running the curb provides a significant speed advantage. So in this case, the damper on that particular side of the car can be adjusted specifically to suit that curb. Now, tuning these dampers is really tricky and requires quite a lot of involvement from the race engineers, and this is why we can see there is a linear travel potentiometer fitted to the damper. This tracks the movement of the damper, and this can be then analysed in log data when the car comes back into the pits. While the damper setup itself is relatively conventional, if not slightly more advanced than what we'd see in a road car, where the LMP2 car is a little unique is that they also use what's referred to as a third element or third member, and this is essentially another damper. Now, the way this works is that because these LMP2 cars produce so much downforce, if we weren't to run a third element in the car and instead we're relying just on the damper and spring setup, what we'd end up with is a setup that either was so stiff to cope with the downforce produced at high speed that it compromised the car's performance in low speed corners, or alternatively, if the damper and spring setup was tuned for low speed corners, at high speed the downforce would simply drive the whole car into the track. In order to deal with this, the third element basically is used when both dampers compress at the same time, so this would be as a result of downforce being applied to the front and rear of the car. The third element operates through what on face value looks like a pretty complex system. However, it's really there to provide an anti-roll bar effect as well. When both dampers on each side of the car are moving together, this anti-roll bar has no effect and the third element is moved in and out as the car moves down in ride height. However, if one side of the car moves relative to the other as the car rolls in a corner, the anti-roll bar comes into effect here. And this is essentially a torsion bar that runs down to a lower pivot point on the top of the transaxle. In order to make a change to the anti-roll bar stiffness, this actually requires the torsion bar in the system to be removed and replaced with a different diameter bar. While there's a lot of complexity in the suspension system, it all really comes down to optimizing a high downforce car to give the best compromise between performance and a low speed corner without ending up bottoming out on high speed straights.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.